Humans have always utilized the Earth's resources. Now they are placing ever-growing demands on these resources and adapting them to suit their changing requirements. As well as rivers, lakes, and oceans, it is primarily the soil and the land which are altered and cultivated. Due to the constantly rising demand for food and energy, humanity is reaching the limits of what the Earth's ecosystems can provide and is consuming more natural resources than are regenerated. The result is growing competition for resources. What are the consequences of the rapidly changing land use for humans and the environment? And what do future sustainable land use strategies for the limited resource land look like? These are the core questions of the Helmholtz Center for Environmental Research, in which scientists from the Project Land Use Conflicts collaborate interdisciplinary. We're in Saxony-Anhalt, in an area of investigation used by the Helmholtz Center for Environmental Research. A cornfield near Schafstedt. It's an example of intensively used land with potential for conflict. Biologist Dr. Stefan Klotz is leading the integrated project. We're standing in a very intensively used agricultural landscape. Here, agricultural production has reached its maximum. Any farmer would be very pleased with this site and could expect very high yields. So what is the problem? The other services that a landscape needs to provide will suffer as a result. A water management expert would worry about the nitrogen content of the groundwater, the substances being discharged from this agricultural land. In these enormous fields, wind erosion is very high, especially in spring and after harvesting, with the result that huge amounts of topsoil are lost. Who would want to come and spend time in such an emptied landscape? And finally, in this landscape, there is very little of the original biodiversity left. But it is by no means impossible for biodiversity in modern agriculture to coexist. The simple measure of allowing richly structured landscapes enables a variety of plants and animals to find a habitat despite intensive agriculture. This can be seen in an area of investigation near Friedeburg, where the landscape is a combination of farmland and relatively untouched areas. Here we have an example of a multifunctional landscape. And here we can demonstrate very clearly that these fields and these crops are benefiting from the level of biodiversity in the landscape. The rapeseed grown here depends on pollination, and the success of pollination can be seen in the number of seeds in a pod. Lots of seeds are a sign of good pollination. Few seeds indicate poor pollination. What are concrete recommendations to eliminate possible conflicts between biodiversity and the necessary agricultural production? To answer the question, the project is based on cooperation between natural and social sciences. Based on experiments, monitoring, modeling, and scenario analysis, the scientists are able to answer complex questions. For example, to what extent biodiversity contributes to the stability of crop yields, and how these relationships are sustained under the influence of climate change. One focus is the quality of the soil. How does land use affect the diverse functions of soils? In order to understand the complex interactions between management and soil, different intensively used soils are comparatively analyzed. This, in turn, helps to evaluate soil quality and develop management strategies for sustainable use. Soil consists of mineral and organic materials. Here, for example, we can see remains of plant roots. But soil is also extremely rich in various organisms, from insects to microbes. Soil is essential to the function of the carbon cycle and the nitrogen cycle. It filters water, ensuring that groundwater is of good quality. And last but not least, soil is vital to agriculture. It's an ecosystem in its own right, but we still need to learn a lot more about it. The data and findings obtained through the project will allow the researchers to create land use scenarios for different spatial scales. The research team in this project is also developing action plans for the sustainable use of natural resources at an international level. Scientists from the Helmholtz Center for Environmental Research advise the Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services, IPBES, and make recommendations for the achievement of the United Nations Global Sustainability Goals. A total of 80 researchers, coordinated by the Helmholtz Center, are working together as part of the project Land Use Conflicts, one of 10 interdisciplinary research projects. Our project adopts new approaches to the landscapes of the future. These are the landscapes that will ensure food security, provide clean groundwater, and have recreational appeal. These landscapes will be biologically diverse and retain this diversity for the long-term benefit of future generations.